think I might give away a million bucks. I think I might give away a brand new truck.
So I guess there's an accident. An accident just happened. There's dead stop traffic, and that kind of sucks because it's gonna take a lot of time off my trip. I'm supposed to be driving, but oh my goodness, all that red, we're right there. All of that, that's like, oh my, an hour of just traffic, and that's like 10 miles, not even.
To feed, yeah, so high, got them riding on E. Daddy needs shoes and kids gotta eat. They can have every last penny on me.
All those guys you saw on the side of the road, those trucks and the RV and the car, they were all involved in the accident. And it looks like it wasn't that bad, so thank God for that. I just needed to document this. I was approached 20 minutes earlier, right before I ate my food, and she needed a ride to Tennessee, but I'm not going to Tennessee. She was a lot lizard.
Might be able to drown a portion of his mind, which is trapped in the infinite horrors of his 1972 through 74 tour through the flames of the big hell.
Sometimes gunfire's brighter than the sunshine. Sometimes a child's scream influences every dream. Sometimes we fool ourselves into thinking we moved on. But no way, no how, do we ever forget what we've seen? No way, no how, do we ever forget what we've seen? No way, no how, do
we. All right, time to go home. Finally, we're done. We're going home. While I eat these delicious White Castle burgers. One more review, what do you say? I say yes, because there's no way I'm throwing those away. I changed my mind. I'm not gonna sit here and review White Castle all over again. Instead, I'm gonna stop filming myself. And if you want a review, just watch Harold and Kumar go to White Castle. That's all the review you need. Yeah.
Sometimes gunfire's brighter than the sunshine. Sometimes a child's scream influences every dream. Sometimes we fool ourselves into thinking we moved on. But no way, no how, do we ever forget what we've seen? No way, no how, do we ever forget what we've seen? No way, no how.
Well, at my job, we don't rip out people's hearts for money.
Well, all this crime and violence, trials and tribulations. Well, unemployment, I breed up youngster boy, and them for no. Vice of the one riot alongside Gang Marley, where some guy feel like.
Let you guys know that in Iowa and Nebraska, there's a lots of hemp or cannabis that's left over from the early settlers when they used to actually cultivate it legally without having to be worried about getting thrown in prison or it was on the side of the road growing there naturally. And there's a shitload of it. It's everywhere. Anyways, it's not smokable.
So long story short, 100% natural cannabis sativa. That's probably got very, very low amounts of THC in it. I mean, extremely low. Not enough to get you high. There are some out there that can't get you high because I've experimented with them in Romania. I mean, it's as natural as it gets. It doesn't get more natural than that. That's self-sustaining itself on the hills and the plains of Iowa and Nebraska. And I'm sure there's other places around America where it grows. And then you get thrown in prison because you have a little bit of a plant that naturally grows on the side. If you pick that plant, you get thrown in jail, which is ironically moronic. First of all, you guys had no right to make it illegal in the first place. It's a God-created plant.
Said they can't find a job, so at night they kill and rob.